I'm Sebastian Davies, a learning experience expert at Dassault Systèmes. Hello, and welcome to this video on leveraging rich lines. Rich lines let us draw from 2 to 16 parallel linear lines simultaneously. The number of lines, the spacing between them, colour, and line style are controlled by the DraftSight options. We can have multiple rich line styles that can be shared between team members to help simplify the designs. In this video, we will look at how to create and use a new rich line style to indicate our external walls, then load and use a style that another team member has shared with us. So, let's get started. We are currently working in an architectural floor plan, but there are no external walls and some internal walls are also missing. Rich lines are ideal for creating these and ease any future modifications, as we will only have a single rich line entity to manipulate. Before we start using the rich lines command, we will create a new style via the options, drawing styles. Since we only have a standard default style, we will create a new one, calling it external wall. We will be using this style when we return to the drawing, so we will make it active. This means it will be automatically loaded when we next use the rich lines command in the drawing. There are two line properties adopted from the standard rich line style. We need four, so we will create two new ones. We will then change their properties, first selecting the offset for the lines. These are based on a 0, 0 center line, so we will enter -12.5 for the line indicating the internal plasterboard wall line, 0 for the center line, and then 105 and 148 respectively for the external wall. We'll then set the line colors for the two outer lines to white and leave the line style to be handled based on the layer the rich lines are in. There are more options for rich lines, one of which lets us add end caps. These lines are for a wall that will be closed, so we will clear the cap ends options. We can now click OK to return to the drawing and run the rich lines command. We specified the line offset based on the position of our wall studs, so we can use these to set out our wall start point. We then click the next point to place the first segment. Zoom in and click again. While zoomed, we can better see how the line offset works with the 0, 0 center line connecting exactly at the stud with the other lines offset from it. We'll then zoom out and pan to the end of the wall. With the last point placed, we have three of the four walls we need. To complete the process, we can close the rich lines by typing C and pressing Enter. The windows and doors use masks, so we can change the rich line display order, sending it to the back, to clarify the design without having to modify the rich lines. We still need some internal walls, so we will return to the DraftSight options. One of our team members created a style that we downloaded earlier from our network. We will click Load, then browse to its location, select the file, and click to open it. This lists all of the styles in the file. We only want internal walls, so select the appropriate file and click OK. We can then select the style from the drop-down and activate it. Then, use it in the drawing to complete the walls quickly while reducing the amount of modification time we will need in future to maintain the drawing.